You're watching Fox NFL Sunday.
The third quarter, the Jets lead the Vikings 20-7, and this first half highlight is brought to you by 1-800-COLLECT, and it set the tone for the Jets today. A 66-yard punt return by Leon Johnson to give them a 7-0 lead, and they've never been headed.
No, they've been playing well the whole first half, and you're right, it did set the tone, and it was Leon Johnson's power at the start to be able to run through the first tackle, and then he's into the end zone, and really, they haven't looked back since.
Keys for the Jets today, of course, the special teams, the punt return for the score, a 41-yard kickoff return, a penalty that went against the Minnesota Vikings, the Jets winning the way they've won, but there are other things as well as to why they're leading by 20-7.
Well, two things stood out to me in the first half. First of all, I thought on third down they did a pretty good job. I think they were converting almost half of their third downs, which is big. And then more important than that, I think their offensive line has played very well. I think the offensive line has protected Neil O'Donnell. He's been able to throw well, and they've been running well. And this group right here, I haven't really said much about them, but they've been quietly getting the job done, and I think they're the difference in the game.
O'Donnell in particular, 13 of 18 for 110 yards and one touchdown. He has thrown only three interceptions all year, so he has avoided the big mistake this season. And if you take a look at the halftime statistics, it's deceiving as far as the total yardage being equal, but you mentioned the third down conversions, and that's huge.
And that's on both sides. See, 0 for 5 on third down. That hurt them last week. And then also penalty free. You see this down here? Nothing down there. Total yards and all that stuff. Those numbers, you can look at them, debate them. But the bottom line, they were converting third downs, and they haven't been hurting themselves.
Vikings getting their only score when O'Donnell fumbled when he was hit. Dwayne Clemens knocked the ball out. Randall recovered, and Jake Reed caught a touchdown pass. So for the second straight week, Dennis Green has a problem. He has the Vikings with a big deficit going into the third quarter.
Okay, now here's a big key right here. The Minnesota Vikings are going to kick off. They've got to hold them and get some points. Last week, Dennis Green told us that the opening of the second half was a key to them. They needed to be able to get points, and they didn't get it. And now they've got to be able to hold them, something they haven't done very well in the first half of this game.
And what the Jets haven't done this year is lose after leading at the half. They're 5-0 this year with a halftime lead. So Mitch Berger starts the second half off, and Aaron Glenn on the return for the Jets. And Glenn with a return to about the 26-yard line.
Wayne Neal O'Donnell has thrown the ball is what Bill Parcells wanted him to get done. You can see he's only been 2 out of 3 past 15. Everything else has been underneath. 11 out of 15 underneath. Now what that means is you're getting rid of the ball quick. See it, get rid of it. When he holds on to it and is indecisive, that's when he's had problems.
Bill Parcells, whose Jets could move into undisputed possession of first place in the AFC East as the Dolphins are losing to the Patriots 24-3, and a win would do that for them. First down from the 26, and here is Adrian Morrell, who gained 52 yards on 14 carries in the first half. He picks up just 2.
And the New York Jets are running the football well. Like today, one of the guys who kind of goes unnoticed but does an excellent job is Kyle Brady, their big tight end, number 88. 270-pounder, really not the receiving threat that they would have liked him to be, but he's an excellent blocker. Gets his hands on you and stays on you.
Second down and 8. O'Donnell's toss is caught by Baxter.
Oh, he tackled himself.
Gets up and finally is ridden out of bounds. Baxter, who caught a touchdown pass in the first half.
That was a good spike. That thing went about 15 feet in the air.
Would have been good if he had been in the end zone.
See, what happens is now you go in the sheet at the end of the game and you look down tackles. And it's going to say, you know, Ed McDaniel so many, Washington so many. 30-yard line, 1 on Fred Baxter. The 30-yard line reached up and got it. There's a tackler right there. He's having himself a good game.
Can't use 12 men, however. Okay, third down and 4 out of the shotgun. Pressure on O'Donnell. It's tipped and caught by Wayne Trebek. And Robert Griffith brings him down at the 43-yard line of the Vikings. So a tip ball into the hands of alert Wayne Krabet in a gain of 24.
Guy always makes plays. Like you said earlier, give him a chance, he'll make a play. Robert Griffith was on the backside of coverage. He was locked up on him. Krebet just ran right by him. One thing Krebet does very well is he can run. See, Griffiths made a mistake by looking back inside at the quarterback. You can't do that. You have man coverage, you see nothing but the man.
First down, Jets on the Viking 43. They spent most of the game, it seems, in Minnesota territory. And this pass to Baxter. Fine catch with Griffith defending. And a first down of 15 yards.
See, Robert Griffiths is mad. He's saying, Baxter, push off of me. They have 5 yards. And this is one of the things that defenders talk about all the time. You can watch him right down here. He's going to be locked up on Baxter. Baxter works the inside. And he gave him a little hit in the top of the head. Just a friendly thing. Pushed off him a little bit and was able to make that. The defenders are all across the league will say, look, if you're going to take away our jam, then you have to let it not then push off down the field as well.
Here's Morrell on first down. Fumble and a loose ball. Clemens made the hit, recovered by the Vikings. And it's Clemens, Dwayne Clemens, starting in place of the injured Fernando Smith. It was forced by John Randall and recovered by Dwayne Clemens and the Vikings. Now with a fumble recovery, that's the second time today the Jets have fumbled. That's not what Bill Parcells wants.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Mazda. Come see what happens when a car company has more engineers and fewer accountants. Mazda. By 1-800-COLLECT, the way we call collect today. And by Snickers. Not going anywhere for a while? Grab a Snickers. Hungry? Why wait?
Vikings recovering a fumble. It was Randall who caused it. Clemens recovered it. Second turnover by the Jets. Vikings capitalized the first time this happened. They're on the 31-yard line, and Leroy Horde, who has not seen action today, the power back, gets good yardage on first down, and 7 to be exact.
Well, in the first half, Dwayne Clemens caused the sack. John Randall recovered. This time, John Randall, watch, he's going to take that right arm right there, slaps the ball out, and Dwayne Clemens is right there to recover. So they're going back and forth. They got their little game going. And that was big because they needed to stop.
Leroy Horde in for one play, comes out, replaced by Robert Smith. Second down and 3. And they go to Smith. Smith is tackled, and that was Hugh Douglas. Not getting as many sacks this year as he's had in the past in the 3-4, but he penetrates nicely, and Smith is tackled for a 4-yard loss.
Well, Hugh Douglas is not the biggest guy. Hugh Douglas, right here, does a good job of working on Stussy with what he does best. He's a movement guy. They have him working a 2-gap, which is more of a power scheme. We have to stand in there, take on the block, and then make the offensive guy make a decision.
3rd and 7. Brad Johnson has time. It's batted at the line of scrimmage. So the Minnesota Vikings go 0-for-6 on third down conversions. Bobby Hamilton, number 92, got a hand up.
I think as good as Minnesota has looked this year is as bad as they've looked in the last 2 games.
And then you wonder whether the Vikings, when they were winning those 6 games, coming from behind on many occasions, never putting a whole game together, what were they all about then? So Mitch Berger will kick it away, and Leon Johnson back for the Jets. A short kick, and Johnson bobbles the ball and then holds on to it. He muffed it and then squeezed it at the 36-yard line. Timeout. We'll be right back. First half. Last week, 4 in the game, only 2 so far in this one, so he has been nullified for a second game.
I think they're nullifying them themselves. I don't think that's smart football. You have Chris Carter, you have a matchup against a smaller man, you make that guy, Aaron Glenn, prove to you he can cover you. And if not, you work him to death. And they haven't utilized that today, and I think that's a mistake.
You have to go with your weapons, and he's one of them. Morrell with a couple of yards. Jeff Brady right in the middle.
Guy who has to pick his game up, in my mind, for the Minnesota Vikings off their defensive line is Jerry Ball, number 96, and he's in there right now. Jerry Ball is the guy. Generally, they go 3-on-2. They're, John Randall is taking the double team. Jerry Ball's got to make more plays and hold up the middle.
Former Raider started his first game for the Vikings last week in Detroit. Second down and 9. Play action. And there's Lorenzo Neal up the middle, gets by Dixon Edwards and Orlando Thomas, and grapples his way into Minnesota territory. A gain of 14 and a first down.
A nice job by William Roberts working on Jerry Ball. Here comes Jerry Ball working. He's going to get single block. William Roberts does a good job. See how he sinks down? And then he gets help from the inside from Duffy. You get that kind of pass protection and inside, that means you can step up and just find your receiver.
Jet offensive line having a big game. First down at the 49. Here is Morrell. Adrian Morrell gets a first down and more as he is hit out of bounds by Orlando Thomas inside the Viking 30. That's a 17-yard pickup for Morrell, leading the Jets in running.
And he should turn around and kiss Lorenzo Neal. Watch him right here. Number 22, Lorenzo Neal, and then McDaniel, boom, right there. And then a good job by Jumbo Elliott, been able to take Alexander. And then on the other end, you got people working downfield, and that's Keyshawn Johnson working on Washington. Just acting as a shield and allows them to pick up more yardage. You know, Dick, I can't tell right now if the Jets' offensive line is playing well or Minnesota's defense just stinks.
There'll be a combination of the two. First down, Morrell again, nothing there. Morrell has gained 69 yards already today after picking up 61 in the entire game against the Bears a week ago. One of the goals of Bill Parcells to get Adrian Morrell going again. And O'Donnell, and you have to say, so far it's been a success on both fronts.
I think they're playing well. I think they're playing real well. And I happen to believe it's less than Minnesota stinking as much as this New York Jet offensive line coming off the ball.
Second and 11, O'Donnell throws it away. It was Keyshawn Johnson who broke off the route, who claimed he was pushed by Corey Fuller.
Now this is what happened with Corey Fuller earlier. See, Corey Fuller's playing is very smart. Get your jam, use him, use the sideline as your friend. See, he gets his jam right at 5 yards and forces him out of bounds. Neil Donald's trying to throw the ball up the field, and he's going, hey, what's going on? Part of that is Keyshawn Johnson has to learn to fight through a jam. We have to fight it all the way.
Jets with the edge and ball control. 15 plays, more than the Vikings run off thus far. Third and 11. O'Donnell out of the shotgun. And this pass thrown out of bounds, hitting the photographer, and a few photographers hit each other. It's not easy, and a little help. Orlando Thomas is going to lend some assistance.
And the best part, the guy popped right back up, but it's like incoming. Every man for themselves, you know. Here comes a mortar, and all they do is put their hand on top of their head and hope nothing hits them. Did you ever notice when somebody says heads up, like a dope, we all look up, and like it's going to hit us right in the nose.
Instead of heads down. Good point by you. 51-yard field goal attempt by John Hall. On fourth down, Hall gets all leg into this, and this kick is good. John Hall, the rookie from Wisconsin, a 51-yard field goal, and the Jets have added to their lead. 23-7, the score over the Minnesota Vikings, as things going the way of the Big Green this afternoon. 16 unanswered points to take a 23-7 lead. John Hall, for the fourth time, kicking the field goal 50 or more this year. And for the seventh time this year, has three or more field goals. He had three last week against the Bears, has three in this one. And now kicking off to the Vikings, who have a little larger mountain to climb. David Palmer on the return for Minnesota. And Palmer is tackled at the 22-yard line with 8:06 remaining in the third quarter. Tackled by Ray Lucas, who's done just about everything today. It's a weekend of championship skating on Fox as Olympic hopefuls take to the ice. Catch world champion Tara Lipinski and some of the world's best skaters as they compete in the Prime Stars Skate International Champion Series. Coverage begins Friday at 8 on Fox.
I'm surprised Ray Lucas isn't skating. One of the things, he's done everything else here today, running down on kickoffs. You know what impresses me the most about it? He understands how to plan. See, he stays in his lane.
from the 22-yard line, and this catch by Evans, the fullback, for a minimal gain on first down.
There's something about a guy like Ray Lucas who's on practice squad and does all the things they ask him to do. Now you take him and you put him right on special team. Hey, you have to have a feel for special teams. You have to know how a guy's blocking you and how you have to maintain the discipline. And he's done it pretty well here today.
And he is the second quarterback for the Jets. Chuck Clemons is the emergency quarterback with Glenn Foley sideline. Second down and seven, Leroy Horn, who is the power runner on this team, but the Jets quickly pursue out to the outside and a gain of 3 yards. Jerome Henderson led the charge for the Jets.
Last week, the Minnesota Vikings learned that they couldn't win one-dimensionally. A part of that is falling behind. And right now, you're down by 16 points. You still have to maintain balance, but you have to have more of the bounce, more of the pass setting up your run.
Third down and four. Brad Johnson for Reed, and it was overthrown, tipped by Henderson, and not a good pass by Brad Johnson.
You had Chris Carter working outside on Aaron Glenn again, and they did not go to it. I'm missing something. Now you can see the difference right there in size. There's going to be a safety sitting down on top. Make this guy have to try to beat you.
Mitch Berger gets off a high, good kick, sending Leon Johnson back to the 25. Leon Johnson, with a head of steam, gets to the 38-yard line, and the Jets will have good field position, leading 23-7 with 6:38 remaining here in the third.
NFL Sunday is brought to you by Honda, vehicles designed to help simplify your life.
Back at the Meadowlands, it's getting close to crunch time. The top six make the playoffs. The 49ers, Packers, and Giants right now are division leaders by virtual tiebreakers. Minnesota, Tampa Bay both trailing right now. Tampa Bay to the Bears, Minnesota losing here to the Jets. Dallas and Washington trying to climb up. And number 80, again, having an idle afternoon.
Oh, he's a disgruntled individual.
First and 10 at the 38 for the Jets. Adrian Morrell up the middle, and he gets to the 45. And right now for a McDonald's game break, let's return to Joe Buck at our Fox Television Center in Hollywood.
All right, guys, in the battle at Lambeau, a little touch pass from Favre to Chimura for the touch. Green Bay back up 17-10 early second half, trying to win their 22nd regular season game in a row at home. Forget about it. Back to Jersey, Dick and Matt.
Okay, Joe, forget about it.
Forget about it.
I hope Joe got something to eat with Bill Moss, though.
I would bet him. I put my money on Moss.
Second down and three on the Jet 45. Here's Morrell. First down into Viking territory. Morrell having a fine game, picks up 8 yards. Orlando Thomas and Corey Fuller made the tackle.
Tell you who else is having a fine game is his offensive line. Now I want you to watch. What they're doing is they're getting a body on everybody, and they're staying with it. Nice job down below by Burke. Nice job by Big John Elliott. Matt O'Dwyer inside. Duffy also. They have a good day. David Williams also. Just getting the bodies, staying on people, and then just letting Aiden Morrell get his 84 yards.
Came in sixth in the AFC in rushing. First down for the Jets on the 47 of Minnesota, and playing a lot in this series with three tight ends playing smash mouth power football the way Parcells' New York Giants used to play, and a gain of 4 for Morrell.
And here, now watch, I want you to watch Kyle Brady. This time he's going to be working on a tight end. You remember, he's 270 pounds. There's another knockdown. I want to show you something of Kyle Brady on the front of his helmet. Anytime you start to see the marks, see those marks right there in the front of the helmet? That means you're getting some good headbutting going on. That means he's getting some good blocks.
Second and six, and O'Donnell looking to throw, and nearly goes down. He's got Brady. Brady fumbles, and now the rule incomplete. Incomplete pass on the play. As Brady did not have possession, and Robert Griffith Dixon Edwards is yakking back to Brady about something, and Brady didn't like it and pushed him back. This is just a delay. He's going to wait. There's the coverage. They both headbutt each other. Now he's just going to come off underneath. Oh, that's a catch. It's a catch unless, you know, he can't see right there, unless he didn't have complete control if it was sliding down his hip. But it looked from that angle like he did have control, and it should have been a fumble.
Third and six, Dedrick Ward, a rookie from Northern Iowa, haven't seen much of him today, comes in the game. Four wide receivers for the Jets. And the pass to Keyshawn Johnson, and he cannot hold on, defended by Corey Fuller, who knocked the ball out of his hands. That'll bring up fourth down.
That was awful close. He had some time to throw that thing, and they've been able to get John Randall blocked inside. And then I want you to watch Corey Fuller right here, number 27. The ball's in the air. Oh, baby, guess what? That should have been a flag. Yeah, but, you know, it kind of works out. And one should have been a fumble on Brady, should have been a flag there. I guess they work out.
And here's Brian Hansen kicking to David Palmer, who calls for the fair catch. And they stepped on the line. And that'll be a touchback. David Palmer came in leading the NFC in punt returns, but he has not been able to get one going. Here's Marcus Coleman.
Watch this official right here. See him? He's looking right at the line. As soon as he touches, touchback. Great call.
You're all set. Have a pleasant flight.
Here you are, sir. A two-door spec.
Spec?
Our junior executive suite.
Supersize me.
Sure, what would you like?
I don't care. Just supersize me.
Did somebody say McDonald's?
Thought about shaving so you could think about something else. Brawn, smart thinking.
I'm in the mood for love simply because you're near me.
The new Accord V6 Coupe from Honda. What'll it do to you?
Wonder how these incredible illusions are done? We'll show you in the controversial Fox special, Magic's Biggest Secrets Finally Revealed, tomorrow at 9, 8 Central.
There is the matchup the Vikings have not taken advantage of. Aaron Glenn giving up several inches to Chris Carter, who has caught only two passes today, obviously showing his displeasure on the bench during the last time the Viking offense was there. And now let's see what Minnesota does, trailing 23-7 with 4:13 to go here in the third. Start with a running play to Robert Smith for a couple of yards.
We've been talking about Chris Carter and the matchup, and here's what I think. See, I think if you have the physical matchup, you're going to notice there's not a ball thrown this way. That's the point. See, you make Aaron Glenn prove that you can cover him. And you're just running routes and saying, okay, the guy's covered. Yeah, the coverage is there, but there's still a bit disadvantage, and he knows it.
Second down and 9. Play fake. Brad Johnson's pass, and this one is caught by Jake Reed. First down to the 39, a gain of 17 yards with Otis Smith defending. Reed has been the only receiver of the Vikings to do anything today.
He's also been the only receiver he's been throwing to.
That's true.
And that's the difference. And I got to tell you something. Otis Smith, who, you know, everybody's been dogging Otis Smith. Otis Smith has been on his coverage the whole time.
Yet Reed is over 100 yards with 5 catches. And Johnson will throw, and there's Reed again. Reed out of bounds. So a big game for Jake Reed, who had a big game against the Jets the last time he played them in 94.
And this is just going to be in his zone. Otis Smith's going to get the jam and turn him over to the safety. And Henderson has to try to get there. And when you're turning it over and you're giving that much room to Jake Reed and that much time for your quarterback to throw, it's tough to defend.
Reed with 131 yards already. He had 121 against the Jets last time he faced them. First down, and Robert Smith inside the 25-yard line and a gain of about 7. Victor Green.
Victor Green made a good play. I'm going to tell you why. Chris Carter is frustrated, and he wants to whack somebody. So he cuts his split down, and he's looking for Victor Green because he knows Victor Green makes plays. Then he missed him.
He whiffed.
Missed him by that much, Agent 86.
Second down and 4. They go to Robert Smith again. And Smith hit by Otis Smith. And short of the first down by a little more than a yard. It'll be third down and about 1. Jets leading 23-7. 3 field goals by John Hall. Great special teams effort, and the Jets lines have been good on both sides. 3rd and 2. Brad Johnson's pass caught by Smith. And it looks as if the Vikings finally have converted a third down. It'll be very close, and it may call for a measurement on the screen pass, and we will call it a first down. So the Minnesota Vikings, after failing the first 7 times on third down conversions, finally make good.
With 1.5 minutes to go in the third quarter, and that's not a good sign offensively. However, that's a good sign defensively for the Jets.
Getting 4 yards. 16-point lead by the Jets. We were tied at 7-7 at one juncture, and the Jets have run off 16 unanswered points. Andrew Glover comes out. And he is replaced by Greg DeLong, number 85. Smith. And it's Mo Lewis who made him give ground. Yeah. Robert Smith has not been able to do much today.
I'm going to tell you why. Because they're trying to attack the inside. But a nice job by the two linebackers and the nose tackle of holding up this inside. Look at this. They're trying to get inside here. Now watch the attack. Boom. There's no place to go. That's an excellent job by the interior 3. And then because there's no room, he's going to bounce it outside, and you win.
The 9th play of the drive, and maybe the final play of this third quarter. 3rd and 5 for the Vikings. And tip ball intended for Carter.
Boy, that was a big play because they finally were going to go to Chris Carter, and he was open.
And that is the end of the third quarter with the score, the Jets 23, the Vikings 7. Fox NFL Sunday will continue after these messages from your local Fox station.
Home Alone 2, Lost in New York, Tuesday at 8, 7 Central on Fox.
It's the next thing. The Panasonic Digital Video Disc will do for movies what the Compact Disc did for music. DVD, made possible by Panasonic. Just slightly ahead of our time. Now get up to 2 DVD movies when you buy a Panasonic DVD player.
NFL rivals go head-to-head with you every Tuesday. NFL rivals go head-to-head with you every Tuesday.
Feel the power of the NFL and collect official videos from NFL Films. It's Look Who's Talking meets the NFL. The folks who invented blooper videos use a little imagination to bring you this audibly unbelievable new comedy.
Game, we're down by 60 points. Just do whatever you want.
Yeah, good call, Coach.
To order your copy, call 1-800-367-7765.
NFL Sunday Ticket. We've got your game.
As we start the fourth quarter, the Minnesota Vikings will go for it on fourth down. They need 5 yards, fourth down and five, trailing 23-7. And they try to go to Chris Carter. The pass was deflected. So a very big play for the Vikings right here. A pump fake by Brad Johnson. And the pass knocked away, never had a chance. Made no Lewis downfield, covering Greg Long. DeLong.
That makes no sense to me. No sense whatsoever.
And the Jets will take over on downs. What kind of a play was this on fourth down?
I think it was a bad call, to be honest with you. You're going to try to work this. They got Greg DeLong working up. Nice job of jostling between Aaron Glenn and Carter. But with the safety sitting to this side, the other side was wide open. He was looking the whole way, and I believe that happened not because of that right there. Here's what was open. See, that was open the whole way. Otis Smith got himself a nice little pull. They were determined to go to Chris Carter that play because on the previous play, he was wide open, came to the sideline, and started yelling at the coaches saying, this guy can't defend me.
So if Chris Carter was distressed before, you imagine what he must feel like now.
But hey, you got to credit Aaron Glenn on that one. That was good coverage.
But the Jets taking over on downs, still leading 23-7. Keyshawn Johnson running after the catch.
I have seen
doing a great job of it. And a first down to the 39-yard line. And a gain of 14, McDaniel and Griffith on the play.
This is, I think, the reason why. This is right before the fourth down. I think that's the reason why they went to Chris Carter the whole time. He was yelling at Brian Billick, the offensive coordinator, and the quarterback. And now sometimes that's good because in Chris Carter's mind, he says, I'm never covered. However, on that fourth down, Aaron Glenn put the clamps on him and did cover.
He came into the game tied for the NFL lead in receptions. First down, Jets on the 39. And this pass out of the hands of Jeff Graham. They haven't gone to him today much, but they've had other receivers.
Dick, I got to tell you something. I think this Minnesota Viking team has missed a ton of tackle. You can see Jerry Ball's working on that right contact lens.
And Jason Fisk, who had the starting position at tackle till Ball replaced him, is in the lineup for Minnesota.
There's no way around. Tackling is a lot of want-to. You got to want to make the tackle. And there's been a lot of missed tackles here today.
First minute of the fourth quarter, second and 10 for the Jets. O'Donnell's pass is caught by Wayne Corbett, and that will be sufficient for another Jet first down shy of midfield.
That looks so easy. And again, O'Donnell getting rid of the ball fast. Another good job by the offensive line. No pressure. And guess what? On the confidence meter, the quarterback is going like this right now. And it's because of this guy right here, Parcells.
No one gets a team ready for a game better than Bill Parcells. He's done it with the Giants, with the Patriots, doing it again with the Jets. He can flat out coach. Keyshawn Johnson establishes a career high with 95 yards in receptions. Jets with the first down with two tight ends. Morrell will lose a couple of yards on the play thanks to Ed McDaniel. Well, let's take a look at the AFC playoff picture where the Broncos, the Jags, and the Miami Dolphins come in tied. But if they lose, the Jets move into first place in the AFC East, so they would move up. Kansas City and Pittsburgh would be wild cards with the Patriots and the Seattle Seahawks, the challengers. Ed McDaniel is shaken up, and Dwayne Rudd, who has played a good deal lately, the number one pick from Alabama, number 57, replaces McDaniel.
That looks like one of those burners where you get an electrical problem down your arm.
Second and 12 on a play fake. Plenty of time for O'Donnell. But he can't find anyone. Buffalo loses it, and Jerry Ball may have recovered for Minnesota.
That's Dwayne Clemens again from the backside. Another good job of awareness. The second opportunity he's had that way, And the second time he slapped that thing down.
Well, they haven't committed penalties, the Jets, but they have turned it over, something that really gets into Bill Parcells' craw three times today. Third turnover of the game, and it was Dwayne Clemens who caused it for a second time.
Meet Sean Graham, veteran stuntman. This is how he lives. This is what he drives. What else would he drive? Chevy S10, like a rock.
They are guardian angels on wheels. Knights in shining armor who ride like the wind. And when lives are at stake, they are the cavalry that always comes through. That's why Texaco tests and retests clean system 3 gasoline under extreme emergency conditions. For all our heroes, for all of us, Texaco, a world of energy.
Introducing Nintendo Score 64 and win at Taco Bell. Just peel the coin off the lid. Score 64, and you could win an N64 system, cash, or millions of other great prizes. And who knows who'll win the Porsche Boxster. It's Score 64 and win. Only at Taco Bell.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Chevrolet Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. By Radio Shack, you've got questions, we've got answers. By Texaco, a world of energy. And by Miller Lite, now official beer sponsor of the NFL.
Well, the Jets have gotten to where they are at 7-4 because they haven't turned it over much. Previous four games, they've turned it over three times, and that was their third turnover today. The Vikings have capitalized once on the turnovers and now have a second chance.
Neil O'Donnell had Keyshawn Johnson. He must have just missed him because Keyshawn was wide open.
First down for the Vikings on the Jet 48. And Brad Johnson out of the backfield finds Chris Carter. They finally got on the ball, and that's only the third catch of the game for Carter.
Hey, I want you to watch Keyshawn Johnson right here and Neil O'Donnell down below. Here goes the play action, runs right by the corner. Nobody there. Look at this. He has time to throw, and there's nothing here. The safety's to the inside. Why he doesn't pull the trigger is beyond me. And then the second opportunity he had, there was nobody there. That had Keyshawn touchdown written all over
it. No question about it. He missed him. First down on a 12-yard pickup on the pass to Carter on the 36. And this pass is caught again. Jeez. By Chris Carter.
There's a surprise, huh?
Where has he been? And he's inside the 10, battling to the 5, not giving in. And the Vikings all of a sudden have a first and goal. And Carter has caught two passes for 42 yards in succession.
Forgive my sardonic ways, but...
You're forgiven.
Yeah, well, you're working... This is something we've seen all game long. And... They're throwing it. They kind of keep doing that.
Well, he's only the leading receiver in the NFL.
But more than that, he's too big and physical for Aaron Glenn to be on all day.
First and goal at the 6. Chris Walsh is in motion. And there's the pass to Reed, and it's a touchdown.
See what happened?
Reed.
What happens? See, now they're going to have to go for 2. But because you start throwing to Chris Carter, your safety's sitting to the other side, now Jake Reed becomes even bigger. Why they haven't gotten it to this point is beyond me.
Second touchdown catch of the game for Jake Reed, and that makes it a 23-13 game.
Remember, Jake Reed, oh, that's a nice move by Reed. He used the jam. Otis Smith came up to get the jam. Jake Reed used the jam against him. When he got the push, he went with the push and got to the outside. That's good football.
Jets sending people on in the quickly. Minnesota perfect this year on two-point conversions. And there is Brad Johnson.
Holy smokes.
That was confusion on the part of the Jets.
No, that was stealing. That was stealing. See, they went with Ghost. Went the other way. Nobody there.
They weren't
ready for
this.
Brad Johnson sees it. Ball comes out.
Here was the touchdown pass moments before. It's now 23-15. And now the two-point conversion by Johnson. It's an eight-point Jet lead.
Hey, Joey, light up the court.
And hit the radio.
Every day, car batteries are put to the test. And every day, America's most trusted lives up to its name. Die Hard. Tried and true.
Once a single library held the knowledge of the world. Centuries later, data was still controlled by an elite few. Then Oracle freed everyone to work with databases. Today, Oracle is putting the knowledge of the world online.
It will forever change our markets and our culture.
Where do you learn about companies whose future is as limitless as our hunger to know? Exactly. NASDAQ.com.
Chevy Venture gives you flip and fold seats, because you never know when a little extra room is going to come in handy. Chevy Venture is here. Let's go.
Chevy Venture, awarded J.D. Power & Associates most appealing minivan in a tie. Let's go.
Revelation foretells the end of the world. Tonight, it's here.
Don't let go. They want you in heaven. They gotta take me too.
A brand new Simpsons, tonight on Fox.
Hey, unless I'm running out of fingers, here we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You have 10 guys. And they're at 11. That means you're minus one. That's good math right there, see?
Boy, that Penn State education does
every time. Now watch. Now they go in motion. He comes outside. Brad Johnson just takes the vacated area. And that what probably happened was that one somebody on that defense for the Jets went to Syracuse.
That's a cheap shot.
And they couldn't get the math down. That's what I'm thinking. Yes. What do you think?
I think you learned very simplistic math. That,
hey, okay, so I got my shoes off up here in the booth. I admit it.
Well, it's now become a ball game with the turnover and the touchdown, taking advantage of the turnover. The Vikings Reed with a second score, and all of a sudden the Minnesota Vikings found a fellow named Chris Carter on that drive. The sun has come out here as the skies have brightened here at the Meadowlands as they brighten for the Vikings. Kicking off will be Mitch Berger. There is the scoring drive, and both touchdowns for the Vikings have come after Neil O'Donnell fumbled. Short kick. Aaron Glenn. And you can hear the players yelling, short, short. And that's, Glenn returns it to the 26.
And that was Aaron Glenn, because that's his job.
Next week, it's another great day of Fox NFL Sunday, starting with America's most watched pregame show. Then don't miss the 49ers as they head to Kansas City to battle the Chiefs. Or the Buccaneers meet the Giants right here at Giants Stadium. Coverage begins at noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific on Fox.
See, Green Bay went up again, scored another touchdown after Dallas. Now it's 24-17. Green Bay.
And the Bears lead the Buccaneers 13-7. First and 10 at the 25. Here's O'Donnell against Keyshawn Johnson, who gets hit by Griffith. Completed pass on the slant. And right now for a McDonald's game break, let's return to Joe Buck at our Fox Television Center in Hollywood. Joe?
All right, guys. Matt, it was another farm to Chimura touchdown pass, but following that, the Dallas Cowboys cap a 68-yard drive and this 21-yard run by Emmitt Smith to close it down to a seven-point game. The drive took only a minute 48 seconds. Early fourth quarter, back to the Meadowlands. Dick and Matt.
Heck, was that Jerry Jones coaching on the sideline, or just, what was that?
Take your pick.
Is that my pick?
Keyshawn Johnson has gone over 100 yards in receiving for the first time in his career, and the Jets are short of the first down.
Keyshawn Johnson is getting coverage where they're not being physical with him. He's using his big body, and what he's doing is what good big receivers do, is they use their body and get it between the ball and the defender. And so even if the guy's on top of you, the ball's thrown inside, there's got to be a completion.
Second down and one as Keyshawn Johnson having a big day. And his Jets leading 23-15. New England leading Miami by 10. Second and one, and the give to Lorenzo Neal. Former New Orleans Saint finds an opening up the middle and a first down, a gain of 8 yards.
I like Lorenzo Neal. Every time I watch him play, he plays pretty well. He's a kind of a squatty body. You know, he's not the tallest guy, but he's powerfully built. And from his waist down, boy, he's really put together. 240 pounds, he's 5'11", but he's a tough guy. And that's what I like about him. And I think when you look at Bill Parcells and his, and you look at what makes up his team, I think Lorenzo Neal, there's a lot of him. There's a lot of tough guys.
First down at the 43. And O'Donnell is going for Quebec, but it's a double cover.
Oh, nice catch.
And
now
O'Donnell threw it away.
It's a good completion on the sideline, the guy in the red coat. Now you don't know what to do with the ball. He's holding on. Look at him. You, can I have this? Well, see, if he's smart, he just sticks that right under the coat.
He's got too many cameras, though.
Yeah, he got the hat on going backwards, but he's going to end up. Watch the catch. It's pretty good. Into the sideline. He bobbled. No fair catch. It was a bobble, but it counts as a catch. That's not bad.
He's lucky Orlando Thomas didn't take him for a receiver. Second and 10 at the 43. O'Donnell getting a rush and getting sacked back to the 35 by Jason Fisk, who came in for the injured Jerry Ball before when he had the...
Came right up inside.
Contact lens problem.
Yeah, Ball came running over to the sideline on that play. Fisk ran in for him, man. He came right up inside. You can watch him right here. Slid the other way. It looks like Pelele just forgot him. They slid right. Pelele stayed inside. Fisk ran right up. It's another one of those things that really is not getting beat physically as much as it is getting beat mentally.
First time O'Donnell's been sacked that he did not fumble today. Third and 17. O'Donnell's pass, it's caught by Quebec. Boy, Wayne Quebec gets the first down. That was a big play for the New York Jets. The momentum was starting to go against them.
He is a tough little punk, Wayne Quebec. You give me him every time. I would take Wayne Quebec any day of the week. He's competitive. He's smart. He knows what he has to do. He sees the whole field. Now watch this. Run. See where he's looking? He's looking to that yard line, Marcus. He knows where he has to get to.
Huge play for Krebet and
look
the Jets.
It. Good for him.
So instead of having to pump the ball, leading by eight, Krebet with his fourth catch, and again, a third down specialist, moves the sticks into Minnesota territory, and the Jets have a first down on the Viking 46. And now the Jets will use up a timeout now, and we'll take a break with 8:53 to go in the fourth.
Bond, James Bond.
On December 19th, the world belongs to Bond.
Grow up, 007.
I'd never dream of it.
Tomorrow never dies. Rated PG-13. Starts Friday, December 19th.
You know, racing for Interstate means my battery has enough power to run my car, as well as some other race necessities, like this mini fridge, my foot massager. Heck, I even had a big screen put in for my friends.
Hi, I'm Bob Vey. Welcome to the wonderful world of ergonomics. What's ergonomics? Ergonomics, the study of man working. Working man. This isn't a table, it's a tool. The table will raise up, raise down. As we make the worker more comfortable, he works more efficiently.
We have a comfort zone between our waist and our shoulders. We've got over 9,000 people working here, so we got to have 9,000 comfort zones.
Instead of bending the person, why not raise the car?
When we're comfortable, we're happy.
Happy workers do make better cars.
I've been the equipment manager for the New York Jets for over 34 years. I've suited up more than 3,000 players. As long as I've worked this long, it's crazy to retire. The Jets are like my family. They're like my own kids.
23-15. Now, how do you get the attention of the head coach?
You go, hey, coach, can I go in? Coach, please, I can make a play. No, really, he grabbed my face. Please put me back in the game. They had a guy to never listen to me.
Don't worry, he'll be back.
Oh, no, he's good. That's a good football player, Wayne Krabbe. That's why he's on that team, because he's a pure football player. Probably you took Wayne Krabbe and lined him up on defense, he'd give you the same effort and be just as effective.
Jets with a first down on the Viking 46. This is a big drive for both teams. Adrian Morrell tackled by Ed McDaniel, picking up five.
Ed McDaniel tackled him for 2 yards extra. And coming from behind. What Morrell has done a great job of today is he's gone away from the point of attack. He's used his vision and his feet at the point and then bounced it. And he has himself 90 yards already. The majority of that has been away from the point of attack.
He's had 3 100-yard games this year. 9 away from another one. Second down and 5 on the 41. O'Donnell looking left, going right, and he's got Brady open. First down and a few more. Big play again for the Jets. First down to the 31. Robert Griffith on the tackle. 10-yard gain. You know, Bill Parcells talked to us about the hidden yardage. The fundamentals that you, why teams lose games, penalties, turnovers, and all of that. The Jets have not had a penalty today, and you have to go back to 1973 for the last time they did not commit a penalty, that against the Buffalo Bills. And that was a game in which O.J. Simpson went over 2,000 yards, a memorable contest. First and 10 at the 31-yard line. Here is Morrell, and he won't get to the 100 this time as John Randall wraps him up.
John Randall made the stop.
You know, when I talk about the point of attack, what I mean is where the play is designed to go. It may be designed to start inside and you try to get a push. Morrell will take that and start there. And if it's not there, what he's done today is he's gone other places. And that involves vision. And then you also have to have good feet. And Morrell has had that today. And really, he's looked like he looked at the beginning of the season.
When he had a big game against Seattle, a tape that Bill Parcells had planned to show his team. Second and 11, it's Morrell, and Jerry Ball got in there, and another loss on the play. Loss this time of 3 yards. Meanwhile, Orlando Thomas has come out of the game. Torian Gray, a rookie from Virginia Tech, has replaced Thomas at free safety for the Vikings. There is Gray, but Jerry Ball making the defensive play.
Orlando Thomas is a player they rely on. The safety, and he's the free safety, and their defense stays deep all the time and then uses his speed to be able to run.
Third down and 14. And a pass to Baxter. Fred Baxter not going to get enough for the first down, but definitely field goal range for John Hall as Dwayne Washington made the tackle. A gain of 11 yards.
So they're trying just to run a little screen, kind of a pick play underneath. The wide receiver will come down and try to get the coverage. And then Baxter slips out into the flat.
John Hall has kicked 3 field goals, but they're not going to send him in right now. At least not yet.
Yeah, this is pretty gutsy right here. 1 score for the Minnesota Vikings and a 2-point conversion.
You're tied.
Ties this bad boy up. So now you got 4th down
and 3.
And they're at least going to think about it. What they'll call the timeout and go up to the sideline and talk it over with Professor Parcells.
And you know that he has been in this position before and probably has the right answer. Second timeout called by the Jets. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
fries, shakes, or pies. I can't make up my mind.
Did somebody say McDonald's?
The Panasonic Razor. Shave wet or shave dry. Your choice, your shave. Rinse clean. Work hard, play hard, shave your way. Panasonic.
Mark, if you're at the airport before my 8 o'clock flight, maybe we can talk. Otherwise, foot over.
Ah! Come on! I'll start. Oh, no! That battery!
No matter what my customers drive, they depend on AC Delco batteries. They last up to 30% longer.
I'm sure they do. Just give me the generic equivalent, okay?
AC Delco. If you're not asking for it, you're asking for it.
No light, no water, no donuts.
I want you to eat me.
It wouldn't have to be if you'd left us some of those chips.
An all-new King of the Hill tonight.
Jets called a timeout and sent their field goal team in. And John Hall, who is connected on three field goals today, including a 51-yarder, his fourth of the year, will try a 42-yard attempt this time with Brian Hansen holding.
I can't imagine that Bill Parcells wouldn't have done anything but this.
This would give the Jets an 11-point advantage. Boy, missed it. And the kick is no good. You're right. And maybe it was the long count, whatever. John Hall hooked it to the left. And the Vikings will take over, and it is still an 8-point Jet lead. And hope for the Minnesota Vikings with 5.5 to play in the fourth quarter.
That surprises me. Because John Hall's had himself just a tremendous year. I mean, he hit this one. He pulled it right from the start. I mean, as soon as it came off his foot, it had that look like it was going to miss, and it did.
Maybe it was the long count. He had to wait a few extra beats than he's used to. The rhythm wasn't the same. Whatever. The Vikings have a life.
Well, now let's see. You see big John Jumbo Elliott right there. Oh, he's a frustrated OT, offensive tackle. Now let's see if the Vikings can continue to find Chris Carter.
They have a first down on their 33, trailing by 8. Johnson getting rushed, and a catch by Reed, and a first down.
That's a great
ad-lib play by both Reed and Brad Johnson in a gain of 12.
That's Brad Johnson. I mean, that's excellent work by Johnson. And then Reed, and I'll tell you why, because Otis Smith's right on top of him. And then he just throws him to the side and does a nice job of coming back to where the football is going to be.
Well, this is where Brad Johnson has been outstanding this year in fourth quarter comebacks. Let's see if he can pull out another one. First down at the 45. Robert Smith almost broke one, but he gets into Jet territory before Marvin Jones makes the stop, but a pickup of 7. Fourth quarter magician has been the label pinned on Brad Johnson. In the last 2 years, he has brought the Vikings back 5 times in the fourth quarter to win, 3 times this year, with 16 touchdown passes and only 3 picks. Second and 3. Here's Leroy Horn, and he's got a first down. So the changeup running back, first speed, then power, and the Vikings get a first down inside the 45. Marvin Jones, Mo Lewis that time. Leroy Horn. He has scored a touchdown in each of his last 3 games against the Jets, so if they get close, he might be a good guy to call on, but right now, that's the man you want to call on. First and 10 at the 43. And going deep. Reed, hold on, juggled it and lost it. Jake Reed had beaten Jerome Henderson, the free safety.
Dick, I don't believe Jake Reed thought the ball was going to get there. Watch, he works, now turns it over to the safety, Otis Smith. Here comes the ball, and I don't quite believe he thought it could get there. Kind of in between, now he sees it and tries to hit the next gear, and it hit him on the arm. And that ball was beautifully thrown. Look at this thing.
comes right down, right angle, watch. Hit him in the left arm. Ran right by the safety.
Second and 10 on the 43 of the Jets. Brad Johnson goes underneath to Greg DeLong, and a gain of about three, that's all. And it was James Farrier, the rookie from Virginia, who applied the big hit.
Farrier has a big upside to him. Bill Parcells likes him, and it's also right now, with 3.5 minutes to go in the game, the time when a big play has to be made, and the Jet crowd knows it.
And the Vikings are going to call a timeout with third down and 7 coming up. That is their first timeout here in the second half.
And so, the prince entered the sleeping castle, breaking the spell as
Hansel and Gretel came upon the evil witch's cottage.
Tinkerbell helped rescue the lost boys from the pirates, and they all...
Now you can buy children a lot of happy endings, because every time you use Visa, we'll contribute to Reading's Fundamental, dedicated to helping children learn to read. So please use your Visa card, because every child deserves a good beginning.
Jack climbed down the beanstalk, narrowly escaping.
Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
The Vikings calling a timeout, their first, and with an 8-point lead for the Jets, this is two down territory in Jet territory at the 40-yard line for Minnesota. Third and 7. Johnson still looking and his pass. He was going for Carter.
There should have been a flag on Chris Carter. And on the other hand, hey, Aaron Glenn played him a nice physical game. The other night, Chris Carter said, I'm going to try to throw this guy all over the place. And Aaron Glenn's got his hands on him. They both got their hands on him. There should be two flags, one offensively and one defensively. That's good defense by Aaron Glenn.
He's feisty.
Hey, he's played himself a heck of a game.
Fourth down and 7. Here comes Glenn, and stepping up is Brad Johnson, running for it, and he doesn't make it. He's short by a yard.
It's his own fault.
The Jets hold him. Mo
he
Lewis.
He tried to slow down to cut back underneath Mo Lewis. And had he kept on running, he had the first down.
And the Jets will take over on downs on the big play of the game.
Well, now they're going to look on Chris Carter to see what he's doing. I can't tell who's holding who. Because he had Aaron Glenn and Aaron Glenn at him. Hey, fight fire with fire. I think that's great. But now watch this. Brad Johnson has the first. All he has to do is keep going. But he was going to try to cut back underneath Mo Lewis. Right there. See, had he kept on going, he had the first down.
They're going to measure anyway, but it appears as if
he was short.
The Jet offense has already come onto the field. And he was, and the Jets get the ball back with 2:57 remaining in the fourth quarter. And Aaron Glenn, emblematic of the spunky, determined style of these New York Jets. And Glenn getting a tongue lashing from Bill Parcells as he comes off.
I don't understand why Brad Johnson slowed down. The idea is not to score. The idea is to get four more downs.
Instead, the Jets take over. First down on the 34. The Vikings have two timeouts left. Yard. And now the Vikings will call a timeout. That'll leave them with one.
That's a good timeout. You got to stop him right there. Brad Johnson's going to be mad at himself for not continue on running. But let me tell you something. On the other side, at 31, Aaron Glenn, hey, crunch time. He knew where the ball was going to go. He knew that Chris Carter was the big guy, and he put the clamps on him. And he stayed physical with him, and he fought physical with physical. high grades for Aaron Glenn.
He did not give in at all to Chris Carter today. And want to remind you, Fox NFL Special comes your way Thanksgiving Day, 11:30 a.m. Eastern, 8:30 Pacific. The Chicago Bears and the Detroit Lions in the traditional Thanksgiving Day game from the Silverdome in Pontiac. Lions coming off a win over these Vikings last week and winning again today over the Colts.
And Chicago winning right now as well. Green Bay also winning 31-17 up there. So Tampa Bay is in danger of taking one on the chin. Minnesota's in danger of taking one on the chin. Green Bay could open themselves a little bit of room in the Central.
And in the AFC East, the same can be said for the Jets. With Miami losing 27-17, the Jets could find themselves, after 12 games, all alone in first place in their division. An amazing turnaround. Second down and 9 after the Vikings timeout. And here is Morrell. And Morrell going over 100 yards, it appears, for the fourth time this year, short of the first down.
That's
by 2 yards.
Good vision by Adrian Morrell.
He's close.
Good vision by Adrian
Morrell. 95 yards today.
Again, that's that thing again, Dick, of just being patient. Running away from where the point is and coming back inside.
In the NFC Central Division, three-way tie for the lead, and now you can look at the remainder of the schedules of these teams. The Packers play at Minnesota next week. Two more road games before finishing home with Buffalo. Looking at that, Matt, who do you think may have an edge, if anyone, with the schedule?
You know what? I don't think anybody. I mean, you look at all these, they're all kind of playing each other, and the Jets have the same kind of thing as well. I mean, they have what this group right now looks like they're going to go to 9-3. These two here look, at this point, like they're going to go to 8-4, which puts them in the driver's seat because they control their destiny. They have Minnesota, so it's in their hands. They have Tampa Bay, so it's in their hands. And then Carolina and Buffalo. So probably Green Bay is in the best position.
Plus, they have the edge in the division and wild card records anyway, and that would be a big tiebreaker. There's Randall Cunningham, the backup quarterback who's had arthroscopic surgery this week. Leon Johnson is in the game at running back. Third and 2 with 2 tight ends. Leon Johnson stopped, who returned the punt 66 yards for a touchdown to stop the open the game is stopped.
Yeah, but they're going to get it again, and that's what they were playing for. That's what Minnesota defense had to do, is to force this fourth down to get the ball back with 2:20 to go. Johnson's going to have one more shot to get the touchdown and a 2-point conversion, but with 0 timeouts.
And there's Brad Johnson limbering up, getting ready for one last shot at the Jets. Time was called with 2:20 remaining.
Looks like Brad Johnson's kind of limping a little bit down here. I'm watching him. He's kind of dragging his leg a little bit.
Some of the Vikings told us last night that he's been banged up lately.
He is banged. I mean, it looked like he's looking at it, like kind of checking out his right leg, maybe his right knee or something. Because when I'm watching him when he walks, kind of drags it a little bit. Yeah, he's testing it. And they're short by quite a bit. And they're going to have to punt this thing and go back to what Parcells talked about. And that's field position and coverage. And his coverage teams have been very good. See how he's walking here? See how he's kind of dragging that leg?
Yep. Yeah, he's not 100%. He's completed 20 of 29 for 254 yards and has thrown 2 touchdown passes, but that man, Chris Carter, has not figured in much today.
They're going to tape his right ankle.
Backup quarterback for the Vikings is Jay Walker, who hasn't thrown a pass. And a 2-minute warning here, and we'll take a break. We'll be right back.
Miller Lite presents...
My name is Melna Knox Moriarty, and this is Blue, but most Saints fans just call her the Fetch Monster. She's an Australian Shepherd, and she's a natural retriever, so we actually trained her to run out and fetch the tea after Saints kickoffs. The crowds love her. The kickers seem to have mixed emotions, but that probably has something to do with the slobber.
Thank you. Stampede tomorrow night, 2 a.m.
You found some quiet, you got some room.
Time to enjoy life and none too soon.
So kick your feet up
and pull your seat up.
Stop making whoopee. You got the moves, your second wind.
Oh, the ride is thrilling, so let the fun begin.
You've earned it all, folks.
And here's the call, folks, for making whoopee.
The new 98 DeVille for the time of your life.
Tonight.
There's something out there. I saw it.
Agents Mulder and Scully discover a new breed of terror. An all-new X-Files tonight at 9, 8 Central.
2 minutes remain in the fourth quarter with the Jets leading the Vikings 23-15. And the question is, can Bill Parcells' Jets hold on? Minnesota out of timeouts. Brad Johnson, who appears to be ailing somewhat, ready to go. And Brian Hansen will kick to David Palmer, who has not been able to return. Two punts today, and he came in leading the NFC in punt return. And now it's time. If he's going to make a big play, now's the time. Conversely, for the Jets, they have to have their best coverage here. And they've had it throughout the afternoon. Short kick, he shanked it.
Oh, thank you very much.
And time for Brian Hansen to shank one, because the Vikings will get decent field position. So Brian Hansen, with less than 2 minutes to go, and you know he'll hear about it.
Oh, boy. Bill Parcells letting him know what he thinks about that shank. Watch Brad Johnson. Watch his right ankle. He slowed down, tried to cut underneath, and right there, watch right there. Right there is where that ankle gets doinked. And he was limping on it. That's a great picture, and you can thank Richie Zients, our producer, who was able to go back and find that.
Great job by him. 17-yard punt by Hansen, and a first down at the 40-yard line, and Chris Carter makes the catch at the 45 of the Jets with Aaron Glenn on his back.
Hurry up, offense.
15.
This is smart.
No timeouts remaining, and the Vikings need a touchdown and a two-point conversion. Brad Johnson looking for help. Chris Walsh makes the grab, short of the first down by a yard. And they can't stop the clock. Second and one, and they have to get it in the end zone.
That's a poor job by Glover, not knowing where to go.
Too much time has run off the clock. Here's Robert Smith.
That one I don't get.
And he doesn't get the first down either.
That was not very bright.
Rick Lyle there, but you wonder about the call.
Get wondering the call. That was a dumb call.
Third down and one. Brad Johnson's pass dropped by Andrew Glover.
But that's okay.
Stops the clock, for one thing.
That was what it did. See what he did? He tried to fake the run like he was going to give some kind of a quarterback draw, or almost like he was going to down the ball to get everybody to watch this right here. See? Like a little fake, and then come back out.
So it's fourth down and less than a yard. And this was the drop by Glover. Vikings 5 of 6 on fourth down conversions this year. Quarterback sneak. And it should be enough for a Minnesota first down, but the clock continues to run, and they've got to spike it again.
I think right there, that was two bad plays.
Three bad plays, maybe. And they spike it with 32 seconds, and the ball at the Jet 35. The handoff to Smith.
I didn't like it all.
The pass to Glover.
At least it stopped the clock, but it was dropped. Could have given the first down.
But if he had caught it, it would have been a bad play.
Well, it would have been, if he had caught it, he'd have gotten the first down. Then the question was, could he get out of bounds? So at least the drop stopped the clock and gave him a chance. However, in that whole thing, you end up losing yourself 25 seconds.
This has not been ideal clock management by the Vikings on this series. Victor Green coming in on Johnson, and the pass to Carter. He's got it.
Oh, there's
Chris Carter is going to score.
Fumble. Touchdown.
Touchdown. He crossed the
plane. Hold on. Inside of 2 minutes, he fumbled it. He's got to recover the ball himself. That is not a touchdown.
And
so that goes back to the point. That goes back to the point. That's right. They've got to get there, force the ball to stop.
We have a fumble inside of 2 minutes. The ball goes back.
Down it.
Oh, okay. They were running a play while the referee was explaining the play.
The umpire set the ball and then stepped away.
The referee.
And generally what happens, see, now Jeff Christie's hurt, and that's bad.
Out of 2 minutes,
he's got
the ball must go back to the spot of the fumble when recovered by another player. It'll be first down.
If Jeff Christie can't get off the field by himself, they're going to run off 10
right.
seconds.
And that'll leave him with 14.
See, now Stussy is getting him off and running right back on. And now they have Scott Dill has run on.
Scott Dill has come on the game. First and goal at the one. 24 seconds to go in a wild finish. Quarterback sneak.
He's not getting in.
And nope. He did not get in.
Not get in. Got to hurry up again.
And now they may not get the playoff.
Now look, they've got to allow them. Now they're stopping the clock. That's the right call.
And we'll find out. There's a flag.
And a flag on top of it. This could be unsportsmanlike. We'll see.
That's the first penalty.
The way of game is on the defense.
Right.
Half the distance. Still taking down.
And it gives them a chance for one more play.
But it's not a bad penalty by the defense. Because you had 8 seconds, and now you get down to 3 seconds. So you take that penalty. That's okay. You got one play. Let's see who comes up. I love this. This is what football is all about.
What a finish. Second and goal with 3 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter. Brad Johnson pass to Glover. Touchdown as time runs out. And the Vikings need a two-point conversion to send the game into overtime. It is 23-21 in favor of the Jets. Andrew Glover catches the touchdown pass as time runs out.
Now it comes down to who can make another big play.
And I believe the Vikings are perfect in fourth and two-point conversions this year, including one earlier in the game. Here it is. And they run it.
That one I
Robert
get.
Smith and the Jets win.
Why? Why?
The New York Jets have defeated the Minnesota Vikings, stopping them on a running play on a two-point conversion to win it 23-21 after the Vikings tied it up or came within two on a touchdown pass with no time remaining.
Question in my mind, okay? Just an observer. Why do you pigeonhole yourself to one thing? You have to give yourself some options. You have a quarterback who can run. Let him buy some time with his legs. Give your receivers outside a chance. Let them use the whole field. You hand the ball off to Robert Smith inside. I disagree with that call.
And for Neil O'Donnell, he came up big today as the Jets won. And our energizer play of the game, the two-point conversion that was missed by the Vikings. Matt, you've already expressed your feelings about the running play.
Good job by the defense.
Rick Lyle. And where was Chris Carter on that situation?
Well, where he was down the stretch was making plays. And again, they only got to him. They didn't get to him enough.
Our energizer play of the game, Carter, who fumbled. And the final score, the Jets 23, Vikings 21. Dick Stockton, Matt Millen. Post-game report coming up when we come back. Scores around the league on the NASDAQ Stock Market post-game report. Final score in a wild one. The Jets 23, the Vikings 21. The Jets go to 8-4, and the Vikings also 8-4 on the year.